Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. You're watching for today. GSI ROM developers community actively working for GSI ROMs now. Orginal developer PHH aka phusson started to work on trebledroid ROMs again, and creative developers like Doze added new revamped treble application with new material you look and more fixes to solve major bugs of GSI ROM. With frequent updates for almost all ROMs like Evolution X, Infinity X, Rising OS, etc. Last time we reviewed the new custom ROM Evolution X V11 version, which was officially available for all supported devices along with its GSI build, which is working for all unofficial devices. But now build had got some new working features and addition of bug fixes for GSI build, which was not available in the previous versions of Android 16 Evolution X. This new version is based on the PHH trebledroid sources, so it will boot and will work fine on most of devices. Today in this video, we have flashed this build on Poco X2, OnePlus 9RT and Nothing Phone 1 and reviewed all of mentioned changes. Today's video is a solid proof that these generic ROMs will boot and works fine on any Android devices. Watch this video till the end, because at the end I shown how you can solve some common bugs using new treble application. Now without further delay, let's get started. For detailed flashing process of GSI ROM on any device, please check iCard video. If you check about device details of this build, this is a PHH trebledroid GSI version of Evolution X 11. This is Android 16 Evolution X with its legendary Easter egg. Security patches of this ROM is of June 2025, similar like its old build. Kernel version will differ as per device you are using. Like here, my Nothing Phone 1 and 9RT have same 5.4 plus kernel version, while Poco X2 have 4.14 plus kernel version. ROM maintainer is same, Doze off. Build date of this ROM is of 6 July 2025, while old build was build date on 26 June 2025. In QS panel, Android 16 version is mentioned as Android 16 BP28250605.031A, which is a beta release of Android 16. As this version is synchronized with PHH trebledroid sources, it have more chances that it will boot and works fine on almost all the devices. Let's check out what are the changes this build have added as compared to old build. New update have new Android 16 notification panel user interface, which have these rounded icons and card look for notification panel. Clear all button is revamped and two different shortcuts are available here, like notification history and notification control. This is exactly similar user interface of new Android 16. User interface of QS panel and QS panel blur is same as old build of Evolution X, which resembles with Android 16. Next is a wallpaper cinematic effect is now working in a wallpaper and style section, which was not working in the previous version. So now we can add 3D animation effect to all third-party downloaded wallpapers. This gives slight animation to wallpapers, which is visible while accessing QS panel, locking and unlocking your device. Under the system and button option, we get the age long swipe back gesture shortcuts. Now you can assign different long back swipe gestures for different activities and can improve multitasking of your device. New build of Android 16 have material look colored lock screen clock for AOD, which was missing in previous versions. Let's check out the signature feature of trebledroid ROMs. These ROM have their own treble setting. This option you will find in a system or its separate application is also available in app drawer. Now its UI is completely changed and it's adopted the new material U 3 expressive design. All options have now well categorized. All features have new toggles switched to enable or disable respective features. Here you get lots of OEM related stuff and features along with bug fixes like Qualcomm devices, Doze settings, display, user interface, audio, etc. I tried some of these settings like IMS option to fix bug of 2G calling, and surprisingly it's work. I will show you how to use this to fix 2G calling issue in a bug section of this video, so stay tuned. These settings are already available from origin of PHS treble ROM, but because of new user interface, it's became more easy to use and understand. So these are all the changes I found. All old Android 16 QS panel user interface, animations, QS panel background blur are available in this build like old version. All Pixel goodies like Circle to Search, Pixel Launcher with all features, Google Gemini, all Evolver customization features are available in this ROM. For detailed review of Evolver features, please check our old video review. Now let's check out which bugs are still present in this ROM and how to solve some of them, so you can get nearly stable experience through this new update. First one is some devices, especially devices with under display fingerprint like Nothing Phone 1 and 9RT will not get working fingerprint. But you can use Face Unlock as alternative, which is blazing fast. While devices with physical fingerprint scanner may get fully working fingerprint like my poco x2. Issue of punch hole camera devices on the left side may face the issue of misalignment of status bar icons. But you can fix it. For that, go to the settings and under the display option, search for display cutout. Here first select hide option and then choose display cutout. This gives the precise cutout for punch hole camera and can solve status bar icon misalignment. Next is issue of 2G calling can be fixed for MediaTek and Qualcomm chipset devices. For that, go to the treble setting. Under the IMS option, tap on create IMS APN. Next, tap and download IMS APK, install it. Next, enable these three toggles. First one is request IMS network. Second, force presence of 4G calling setting. And last, enable allow binder thread for incoming calls. And now reboot your device. After this setting, VoLT calls should work for your device. Only basic integrity is passing in this build. Still, all banking applications are working for me, as you can check in this video. So for poco x2, I think this build have fully stable experience, while for Nothing Phone 1 and 9RT, it's nearly stable build except the bug of fingerprint. I am very glad that original developer PHH, aka phusson, and Doze of working very hard and providing Android 16 test for aged and old devices which didn't have any stock or third-party custom ROM support. This is new hope of life for Android world. This is all for today, guys. Hope you liked our work. Then please do like and share this video. Subscribe to our channel. Press the bell icon for notifications of our upcoming content. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Take care. Bye-bye.